I love money. Mwah, mwah. But money doesn't love me. Every time at the year-end party, when the lucky draw started, I was always excited. This time, it should be my turn to win. When people won a TV, a mini bike, I always got a mini soap. When people won $5,000, $10,000, I always got the high quality toilet paper. It's so unfair. So I whispered to the people beside me, "Hey, look, the TV is so ugly. I will never put it in my beautiful house." "Hey, hey, only $5,000. Does he have to be so happy, huh?" I just can't control my mouth. In Aesop's fables, there is a jealous fox who can't catch the grapes on the vine. So she tells everyone, "The grapes are very sour. Pwee!" Do you know the fox? Stupid, right? People always laugh at her, except me, because I can totally understand her feeling. But there is a lady, no matter what kind of lottery, she always wins big money and treats us big meal. She is my mother-in-law. I ask her, "Mother, why do you always know the lucky numbers?" She answered, "Daughter, imagination. You have to understand the signs from Buddha in your daily life." Oh, imagination in my daily life? But how? For example, one day my daughter was sick. Because of it, my mother-in-law won the lottery. The winning number were 2 and 0. 2, I understood, because my daughter vomited twice. But how about 0? My mother-in-law explained timidly, "When your daughter vomited, ball, the shape of her mouth was a zizola." Jesus, mother, you are a genius, right? And another time, I lost in a speech contest and complained to my husband. Then my mother-in-law pushed my husband away and said, "Daughter, daughter, come here. How many contestants today? How many judges?" And that time, she won $20,000 and gave me $2,000 as a bonus. Mwah, mwah. Losing is so wonderful. But not this time, okay? For such a smart lady like me, I can do this too. Let me try. That night, I dreamed about my husband was in the bed with 2 women. While I stood beside them with 3 flowers on my head, I woke up immediately and wrote down the possible numbers. 2 women, 1 man, 0, 1, 0. 3 flowers on my head. Monica, hey, 8. My number is 3, 8. Strange number, but I bet this time it's gonna be me. Do you know how much I won? Nothing! I lost all my pocket money. And my husband asked me, "Honey, what's wrong with you? Oh, are you pregnant again?" No, but even worse, how come I never win when I gamble? My husband hugged me and said, sweetest people know, marriage is a gamble. And you have already won the biggest prize in this gamble. That's me. You? I cried even louder. I kept complaining and complaining about my bad luck. Finally, my mother can't stand it anymore and say, "Stop, my daughter. Do you know you are very lucky? Look at yourself. You are so beautiful, smart, healthy. Besides, you have a good job and a good family. Tell me, which of these you would like to trade for money, huh? You, silly girl." My mother's words, like a thunderbolt, struck me. At that moment, I finally understood why I could never win the lottery. Because I have already been the richest woman in the world. The two valuable lessons I've learned from my two mothers. My mother-in-law taught me, imagination plus creativity equals good luck. And my mother taught me, always be satisfied with everything I have. If I can't get the grapes on the vine, why not enjoy the strawberries by my feet? So, if I win this contest, that's because you are the best judges and audience. If I don't, I won't say the champion is a sour grape. I will go back to enjoy my delicious strawberries because I decided to be a happy fox contest master.